The Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Dr. Stephen Kazimba Mugalu, has condemned the high cases of domestic violence in families amid the COVID-19 pandemic. He called on Ugandans to return to God. Kazimba was officiating at the Golden Jubilee of Life Ministry Uganda, an organization that promotes Christianity evangelism. He condemned the organization for shaping Christianity through giving evangelical trainings to clergymen.
The Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Dr. Stephen Kazimba, has expressed disappointment with the way this COVID-19 period has seen a surge in domestic violence in families across the country.
The pandemic, for example, has exposed so much gender-based violence. So many of our girls who were in school before the pandemic have either produced children or are now pregnant. This is not right. It's not right. And it makes me very sad.
Kazimba was officiating at the Golden Jubilee celebrations of Life Ministry Uganda. The organization celebrated 50 years of evangelism in Uganda at a colorful event in Kampala. Kazimba commended Life Ministry for mentoring and supporting trainings of members of the clergy.
We thank God that you have also understood the need to support the church from which these youth came and in which they will go when they leave campus. You have also recognized the central role of leadership and the need to support Christians in leadership in every sector of our society. You have supported very many clergy conferences in dioceses of the Church of Uganda over the years. And we are so much better for your investment in us.
Several dignitaries graced the event, including Vision Group Editor-in-Chief Barbara Kaija and the Chairperson of Citizens Coalition for Electoral Democracy in Uganda, Miriam Atembe.
We praise Jesus for the 50 years of Life Ministry as we have lay leaders involved for evangelism. Yes, young men, yeah, old people trained to obey the commission of Christ in Matthew chapter 28 verses 18 to 20 says go into the world and teach everybody to obey and follow the commandments that I've given you, teaching them and causing them to be baptized in the name of the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Outstanding legacy has got to be people, really, human beings, change lives. People, the legacy of Life Ministry in America for me was my own changed life. And I think the changed lives of many people here is the greatest legacy. And we'll all be together forever.
Life Ministry also boasts of several charitable projects which they have undertaken across the country, especially in disaster-prone areas of Kasese and Elgon region. The national team leader of Life Ministry, David Wataba, disclosed plans to strengthen the family institution which has been badly hit by COVID-19.
We decided to put up a program called Family Life. And we have appointed not less than 6 staff who work in this program. We have developed materials. We live, I personally, my home is open up to late hours, counseling marriages. I have known people who have come to my home ready to divorce, but with counseling, they have been able to come back together because they realize one thing, that no one is perfect in a marriage relationship.
50 years down the road, Wataba says the gospel is going to remain the same, but tools are going to change so as to strategically reach more youth.
In the event we are holding today, we have a representation, selected representation of our young people that we wanted to tell that, hey, it is your time to take charge of this country. But also we have decided to have a young leadership, a young management of Life Ministry Uganda to prepare to pass the baton to the next generation.
Life Ministry also awarded 1,200 people who have supported its services in the 50 years. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.